What's up, ladies and gentlemen? You're now watching Kinetic Outcome, and we are now at Hubbly Bubbly with Matt, one of the co-founders, and also he does office as well, business development and project management. So a little bit of introduction of yourself. We can start with where you were born, and you grew up, where you study, then project management, BD, and how'd you get here?
Sure. Yeah, my name is Matthew, and I was 25 this year, and I was born in Australia, actually. And yeah, I was brought up in Hong Kong. So basically, after I was born in Australia, I moved to Hong Kong right away. So I study here, I work here now, and I have my own place here. Yeah, Hubbly Bubbly is a shisha bar, and I'm one of the four owners. And yeah, we opened up for around half a year now.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay. Let's go back to when you graduated from CDU, right?
Yep.
And then you were already doing BD and project management.
Yep. So after I graduated from uni, and I was studying information management back in uni, and yeah. So my first job, which is also my current job, is working in an airline. I was a trainee before, and after the program ends, and I just chose to be in the digital team as a working in the project management industry, the field of project management. I think having my own business starts from back in university. So at that time of period, I don't know what I really want to do. And a lot of people were talking about having their own startup and also or start developing some skills for their future career. So at that time, I kind of into thinking, what business should I start? No matter it's a tech startup or a restaurant or anything, I have no idea at that time. But after graduation, because it's really hard for you to have that power to keep your own, keep that thought, having a startup in your mind. So after graduated, I just got a job like most of the people do. And I think after I have been working for 2 years, and I got an opportunity to open up a restaurant with a bunch of friends. So it was a restaurant. And after that, the business doesn't launch, and the partnership before the business actually goes. And then I was asked by one of my friends, also one of the partner here, Leo, to whether I want to join his team to a shisha lounge. And yeah, so after half year of preparation, and the place was born, and here I am.
So, shisha lounge idea to shisha bar.
Yeah.
So prior to that, you had friends that wanted to open a restaurant.
Yeah.
But was it? It was here, right? In Hong Kong as well.
Yeah. So
just didn't work out.
Yeah, it just didn't work out, and I joined another group of friends, and the idea kind of changed from a restaurant, and I joined a group of friends that want to start a bar or a shisha lounge.
Which became a bar and shisha lounge.
Yeah, at the end, it just combines everything and becomes a shisha bar.
And all of you had enough money to invest already at the time.
Yeah, so yeah, both of all of us has worked for a couple of years already, and apart from all the partners, we also got invested behind our backs, and yeah, so we gather quite a group of people, and we got enough capital to open up this place.
Okay, so how was your journey towards that process, the struggles, but at the same time your rewards now after you opened?
Yeah, it's kind of in the timeline, because in the very very beginning it was always struggling. And as the time moves on, and you start to having the reward. So yeah, for struggle, I think it the very beginning of the business is really tough. So you have to gather the whole the people and gather the money. And also you, because like none of us was in this industry before. So we all are like working in an office or like, or being a cabin crew or even some pilot. So none of us are in the F&B industry or have their own business before. So we know nothing about like how to start a own, how to start a restaurant or how to start a bar in Hong Kong. Yeah, so we do a lot of research and we like visit a lot of like places in Hong Kong and we ask people, we meet people, and we hired people to like be our consultant to how to start a restaurant or a bar in Hong Kong. And I think at that time of the period is the most suffering time because like all the paperwork and all the talking is not something that you want to do.
And licensing.
Yeah, and also of course the licensing is the most complicated thing to do. And yeah, so we have to like went through that period of time. And until I think after we decide which place to rent and decide all the decide all the design of the shop, and everything just like feels like to come to an end, and it just like all everything comes together, it starts to feel more satisfying. And because something that like we started from an idea and we just built everything around it and until it comes to a product, and this brings to like the rewarding part. So I think the most rewarding part, apart from like how the business goes, is it like earning money or like supporting myself? I think the most rewarding thing to have a shisha bar is about like the satisfactory that it brings to you. So, because I always want to have like my own place, not for living, but like a place that I can gather all my friends to like, we have fun, we chill. And I think that's the most satisfying part for having my own business here.
So it's good for networking as well.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, and when you launched before, there were also other shisha and bar owners that were here. So it's kind of like a community.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah. And yeah, because I would say the shisha community in Hong Kong is small. And and people like kind of like know each other already. So yeah, I think the whole vibe for the shisha community is a good vibe.
Okay. And besides this though, anything else you're looking to get into in the future? Like besides F&B related business?
So far, because we still open up this place for only half year, and there's still a long journey coming ahead. And
you personally?
Me personally. I really want to like have this place to be able to like support my own living. And also, if the business is good enough, I really want to have like another store or a branch and whatever. And yeah, and more is to learn about like how to run a restaurant or run a business. So in some day, if I'm not in Hong Kong, I'm still able to be, have a shop in other countries.
Okay, even if it's not F&B, could be retail.
It doesn't really matter to me. So as long as, because having a bar may be something that I want to do like in my 20th. After my 30th, maybe I just want to have a hot dog stand, I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So next question is, how do you feel about Hong Kong's approach to the industry that you're in?
Yeah, so I would regard myself as being in the shisha and also the bar industry. In terms of customer, so most of our customers are like youngsters, like fresh graduates or like around 20 to 30. Mm. And I think people do accept like shishering much more than before. People kind of start to visit more like shisha places and they start learning more about like what is a good shisha and what is a bad shisha. Just like tasting wines or having whiskey. So people like start learning more about that and they look for more quality stuff. And yeah, I would say that the market is growing really fast, and like people are accepting it more than before. And in terms of like the government's approach to this industry, I mean, it's COVID period, and it's very normal to have quite a lot of restriction to like all the restaurant or entertainment industry or bars in Hong Kong, how things are in these 2 years. And I mean, it's kind of a good thing and a bad thing. I mean, like how COVID impacts the having a shisha bar in Hong Kong. Because like in terms of good things, is because the rental goes down quite a lot. So it is easy. The expenses of having a business in Hong Kong is relatively low than before, actually much lower. And the, of course, the downside is the COVID restriction, right? And the behavior of the customer. So people tend to like stay home more, of course, even though the, yeah, we got zero cases nowadays, but people like already got used to like go back home after 10, hang out less. So that's pretty much it.
For the next question, what makes this place unique in terms of your approach?
Yeah.
What do you feel that's unique about it?
So for Hong Kong, I think like the majority of bar are still like all the traditional bars that people know. So like they focus on their drinks and their maybe cocktail bars, or like a more local bar, they focus on like how cheap can you get a pint of beer. So a lot of places still focuses on drinks, but for us, we focuses on both our drinks and shisha. So we kind of like, our main product is our shisha, and we also comes with our drinks. So this is how, there are not much places in Hong Kong that focuses on this right now. This is how we market ourselves, and also how we differentiate ourselves from like traditional bar or pubs.
Okay. And for the next question, what tips or advice would you give to people who want to open their own place, let's say?
Yeah. So because as I said, I was like planning to have a restaurant before, and after that I like created a bar in the beginning, like turns out to be a bar. So I think to open up a business, first you really have to understand how the market goes. Even though like at the time of the planning, and it might take you like a half year to until the restaurant is ready and it launches, right? And even that half year, like the market could change just rapidly. And you really have to like learn about like the market to know about like the demand, and also how the competition will be, how the trend will be. And after all of those insights, and you have to really have to plan it like very detailedly, and also all the financial like forecasts and also planning to have all the preparation like as much as you can. And if you got like friends being in the same industry, go ask them, because like those advices are invaluable, and yeah, you don't want to make the mistake people like made before, right?
Okay, so to summarize, just prepare
yourself
better.
Yeah,
because you, as you mentioned, yours was a little bit chaotic.
Yeah, because all of us are like the first time of having our business, and yeah, no one really got an idea how to do it, like which license to get, which government department to contact. Yeah, and also of course get the money ready, because like I guess every business needs like some money.
Yeah. Okay. And since you mentioned you want this place to be better and more stable in terms of profits, right? So normally I would ask, what is there you think we would look forward to ahead of time. So I guess I will not ask for next year or so, but throughout the years to come, let's say COVID's done, business is back to normal, and this is doing great. How many branches would you think of opening besides this? And would it still include Sisha or different theme?
If everything goes back to normal and the business is good enough, I would first plan to open up only one branch first, because I think having one more branch is already such a very different thing to only have one store, right? Because you have to like have a better like staff management or inventory management or even financial planning and in terms of like risk management, because it's the first time you're having another branch. To me, it's less risky to open up only like one more branch. But of course, in long term, if everything goes well and successful, of course, I want to have like a few more. But yeah, for the whole direction of the place, it's still going to have a similar design and also a similar product. And because we are known for what we what our product are, and we don't want to like change it like a lot, so we could keep our like reputation there.
Hobley Cafe.
Yeah, we're not really into like coffees, and yeah, maybe
there is though a pretty cool spot been to in Central. It's like half is like cafe, and you can order bagel or just different types of, I don't know what you call it.
There's
like
a lot of,
right? And then balcony as well.
There's a lot of places in Hong Kong. I mean, shisha places in Hong Kong also like mixed with cafe and actually different kind of stuff. So people mix shisha with cafe, with restaurant, with bar, with even like library thing and different kind of stuff, or like a share office. So basically you can add anything.
I think the only thing that we're missing right now is like bar, shisha, pole dancers.
Yeah, maybe you can open
it's just
up
a concept, but of course I won't open that.
And
in a joking perspective, but they do have that in Wan Chai, so
is it?
Well, like pole dancer, so.
Oh, so you could bring up shisha there.
Yeah.
You show up with a shisha pipe and they will welcome you.
Yeah. Okay. And next question. I think this could be the last one or second last. Just your journey throughout the process of what you wanted to go for in life in terms of what you're doing now on the office side and this as well, opening this concept. Your support system and naysayers, right? So how was it like? Like, did you have more support or did you have a balance of support and people not supporting your idea on opening this place?
How do I see this business in my lifetime? I would say that I'm glad that I'm doing something that I want to do in my lifetime, because as I said, having my own business is always something that I want to do. And I'm currently in a transition period of the lifetime, because I wanted to have my own business but not like working in an office full time. So I'm now like having both of them, which is quite tired for me. And if the business goes well and I could quit my full time job and like focuses all my energy and time here, and that would be something that I want to do. But anyway, yeah, I think I'm on the right track now. I'll see like what happened in the couple of years. And also in terms of supporter or haters during the whole journey, I say I'm quite a lucky man, because luckily my family do support me for having this business. I think throughout the whole journey, I got more support than more hatred. And yeah, so there was like, of course there was tough times, like people comes and people leave the crew. Yeah, luckily we still made it to today. I would say that no matter like how the business goes, like in the journey of like starting the own business until maybe like the end of this business, already like learned a lot of stuff that I will not be able to involve if I only have a normal office job. I already got what I want, and yeah, so for the rest is only depends on how the business goes and how well do we do our business.
Okay. And I guess last question should be something off of my mind. What would be a good tip from you in terms of just going for what you want?
I think the passion is really something that matters, because there are a lot of time you want to give up, and there will be like uncountable challenges to meet for doing something that you really want. I think the only thing that keeps you from not giving up is your passion to what you want to achieve. And like with that passion and also some faith in yourself, I think like everyone could be able to do what they really want to do.
So I don't know if I said for the previous question last, but this is literally the last question. So there are many people that have many ideas and just many things that they want to execute in their mind, mm-hmm. but never able to do it mm-hmm. until their last breath. So why do you think they're not able to do it and you're able to? What makes you different?
I think I do agree that a lot of people have what they wanted to do, but they just didn't do it because people tends to be like stay stable and not tends to accept changes, I guess. But apart from the passion I talked about before, I guess one thing that is lucky, because I do met good partners, people to like run this business with me, and also people that believe in me to also like support me for this business, comes to the shop and bring their friends here, and also like the support from the family, because I guess not every like parents do support their kids to have a bar in Hong Kong, because it's still like the night industry, and so I'm very blessed and feel lucky that I got all this kind of support from all my friends and family.
So if I were to rephrase that, maybe what you're trying to say is the right group of friends with the right mindset and a good support system.
Yeah, I think just like very supportive and good friends that help you throughout the whole journey and help your business as well.
Okay. Well, I guess that's about it. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, Kinetic Outcome and Matt, Hector, we out.
Our aim is to provide value. So if you like what you watched, make sure you hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. I'm also a financial advisor based in Hong Kong, so feel free to check the description box for my details and email or DM. And if ever you need video and photography services, the phenomenal videos you're watching right now are filmed by Edry Mendoza. Lastly, if you love hip-hop music, rap, R&B, singing, whichever that sounds amazing to your ears, because I always do a lot of experiments with it, feel free to drop by my channel at SCF Saint or Saint Crossfade. Appreciate you for being part of this episode and more to come. Till next time.